our topic, the statement that states that women are naturally inclusive in thought and approach. When we look into this, let us dissect the words and let us look into the word inclusive. When we talk about inclusion, it means actually gathering everyone and putting them together. It also means that the fostering of equality in society and in a diverse society, that is, in any scenario for that matter. And when we are talking about that, it doesn't necessarily need to be a woman who has to foster this or bring about an inclusion. And so
we as a team believe that the onus of inclusion should not just be on women. It's also a man's thing as well. So why should women be considered as a person who should be the peacekeeper of the family or in the society? It can be due to the men as well.
So adding or probably giving a counter to your point, I have a small statement that is, or a quote, as I would say, that I once read, that women are the sons of the family. I repeat, women are the sons, not S-O-N-S, but S-U-N-S, which basically means that they are radiating, they are happiness, they bring up the happiness into the family, and they tie everybody together. They understand the needs. They bring out the best in individuals.
Such a woman has the ability to embrace everyone and move forward in all spheres. And they sacrifice their life not only at the workplace, but also for their family.
So when I talk about, the brightness, the strength, the unity, I mean, it can be done by either of them. But as we see, the woman is the one who holds. She becomes the backbone of the family.
I would like to begin by sharing one statistics. According to a statistics shared by the United Nations, one out of every three women face physical violence or sexual violence every day. Why this is important? This is important for us to realize that one woman is facing the violence and rest two are carrying the fear of that violence within. And when that fear gets ingrained, it becomes very difficult to naturally be inclusive because you're always under the thought of whether you will be judged, whether you will be questioned for being inclusive, for accepting everyone with open arms. Because women should always be, according to the society norms, under cover.
As Rajneesh rightly said, if a woman is marginalized and she is suddenly inclusive, how would she get out? Here, according to one of the statistics, a publication that was put up in Time Magazine, it clearly stated that some parts in India there were women who were forced to follow certain norms. And because of this, I'll continue this in the next.
Now, the very concept when we talk about, initially talked about inclusiveness. Now let us go into thought and approach. If we look into thought, what do they mean? Ideas, beliefs, what has been ingrained from childhood. So it doesn't necessarily have to be a woman whose thoughts and ideas are compassionate, are more inclusive in nature. It can be a man who can actually bring in a difference in the society. And we have many such examples like Mahatma Gandhi or the Dalai Lama, or for that matter, why not take our very own COVID warriors who were there. There were many men who came forward, brought that inclusivity in society, and actually the process and the thought which came into it was exemplary.
And I just want to again restate what I want to say and what these team
there over right now, that it is the onus of women that have to be there. But and again, the family consists of both men and women. So for
I agree with your point that family consists of both men and women. Considering all the norms of the society, I agree with you. You know, but my point is, when the warriors that you've mentioned here, or the societal norms as you speak of, you know, males are the ones who always stand out. They are the breadwinners of the family, right? And we always turn back to the women, be it the grandmothers, be it the paternal aunt, be it the maternal aunt. If there are no males, it is the women who have taken charge. You know, let's go to the Northeast. You know, it is considered as a matriarchal society, right? Where we not only talk about professionally, but personally also, women has the reins in their hands. You know, in certain parts of our country, India, you know, there are at times the males were caretakers and women are the bread earners. So I come back, women not only do it personally, but they do it professionally as well. Be it as
my work equivalent said that women are like the lightning. I here I beg to differ by stating that even men can also be the lightning here. It is not only that women should be secluded to something, even men also can be that. And here I would like to put in the statistic that I was mentioning that there are women in certain parts of India who are followed, who are forced to follow certain norms, and because of this, they are not able to put themselves out. So here, when, if we seek for equality, sadly the women are not able to bring about it.
The statement says that women are naturally inclusive in thought and approach. So when we are being forced to realize that inclusivity has to exist in thought and approach, it vehemently preaches the fact that here inclusivity is a process. So this process needs to be implemented and it cannot exist naturally. Women maybe are naturally, you know, they have the power to give birth, but by condition, by the situation, probably they are opening up gradually to show inclusivity to the world. Take for example Malala Yousafzai. We cannot say that she was naturally an inclusive woman.
Yes, carry on to what with a lot of respect to everyone. I would like to add on to this that men are very good peacemakers. Now, when we talk about peacemaking, when we are talking about the society in large, or even in a classroom situation for that matter, it is not necessarily, and when we are talking about inclusiveness, we are taking all the different types of people in society or in a school situation or any situation for that matter, and including them in our thought process. So if we just stick to only one stereotypical thing, then we are excluding the others altogether. We are excluding the men and saying that we are talking about inclusiveness. How is that possible?
So when we talk about inclusions, right, we mean accepting, we mean generosity, we mean enduring different aspects, different circumstances that women are put into. They have, like we've spoken about, they are forced into something. No, they're not forced into. For example, like marriages, right? If we see a joint setup, right, what are we talking about? We're talking about a newlywed gets into the family, tries to accommodate, understand, and accept each other, and understand what the family is like from where she's come and where she's gone to. The traditions have changed over the period of time, but the role of a woman has to be not that I'm going out, it's my life, I can do things that way. No, she has to take care of everybody, be it an elderly person at home, be it a small child, be it the neighbors, she takes care. And A small little example, during festivities, it is the mothers, it is the grandmothers who are the ones who pass it on.
Thank you, TV, for mentioning this point. This is the entire point of the argument. Women are naturally considered, I believe you have made it more clear, they are not considered naturally to be inclusive. They are naturally considered to be divine. They have this divine power of taking care of everyone, being the peacemaker, being the homemaker, and my question is why? And when it comes to thought and approach, we may all have very varying thoughts of inclusivity. We may kind of, condescend marginalization, but inclusivity also means giving equal access and opportunities to everyone. And I'm very ashamed to say that when I'm traveling in public transport, I'm very happily, you know, taking my seat even where the men are sitting, but when the one man comes and takes a seat in a lady's, occupant seat, I'm the one to protest. So, am I being inclusive naturally, or my education, the situation around me, the violence against the women, not the women. I'll take this later.
Coming back to the topic, women are naturally inclusive in thought and approach. The topic itself seems a little stereotypical, stating that women are expected to be naturally inclusive and in their thought and approach. Are we putting a little too much onus on bringing the family together, bringing the society together, and in each and every aspect of our culture together on women? How is it that women have become the mirror of the society? It is not just women. Society is not just built by women. It is men, women, and children as well. Yes, adding on to that point, that is what we are trying to hard here. When we talk about inclusivity, we have to include everyone in society, not just women. How can women really think of inclusion, leaving out the others? It's not just one aspect. It's not just being in a certain...
So my question to both the team members, we're talking about equality, if I'm not wrong. We're talking about how men perceive it in the society. Then why are we talking about feminism? Why do you want extreme rights? You know, why do you want that women should be given certain privileges as we speak of? My whole idea, going back to the statement that at some point the onus is given, because at some point we look up to our mothers, we look up to our fathers, I don't deny that. We learn our first parent, our first, you know, the one who guides us, who nurtures us, or who even teaches us is the mother, right? Because the child is there in the womb, irrespective of whatever gender the child comes out with, but learns, gets the first education from the mothers. And women makes sure, irrespective of whether, you know, either irrespective of whether she's an educated lady or not, she helps in bringing everybody together.
I humbly beg to clarify, ma'am, on one point. Feminism, the different waves of feminism has made it very clear that feminism exclusively doesn't speak about women's rights. It speaks about equality, it speaks about giving men, women, and people from the other gender communities as well equal opportunities. So feminism is just not wearing a t-shirt from Soul Store saying feminist AF. It's something beyond that. And when we're talking about inclusivity, I would like to make you all aware with one data, that less than 29% of the global managerial positions are awarded to women. So women are not getting that chance to bring about the changes, being the key leaders, probably where the others are getting. So it is not naturally that they are becoming inclusive, but inclusivity is also becoming a revolution for them, which they are fighting for with their life, with their movements, with their words, thoughts, beliefs.
So, with our argument, we would like to conclude by saying that we are in a world which is marred by divisions. We have so many divisions in the world. And again and again, reiterating one big fact that since we are all children of this world, we have to sit together and come together. It is not the onus of women, but also men all around to be a part of this world. Thank you.
So in the end, as I am speaking for the statement, I would like to conclude that women inspire hope. Women inspire, happiness, brightness, unity, right? At the same time, she acts as a catalyst in a family. She is that gap that she tries to bridge and brings everybody together. Thank you. And irrespective of the fact that whatever the time frame is, she tries and helps everybody to finish a task in the stipulated time frame and not leave anybody behind. Thank you.
To conclude, I would just request the dear audience to think. The statement says women are naturally inclusive in thought and approach. So does the statement against say women are not naturally inclusive in thought and approach, or women are naturally not inclusive in thought and approach? If women were naturally inclusive, then probably the number of women criminals would have been zero in this world. The number of atrocities against women by women would have been zero. So, inclusivity is a process which needs to be ingrained through a process of cohesion, collaboration that just not only includes women, but also men, transgenders, people from different gender communities. Let this not be a bipolar debate on whether women are more capable than men in spreading inclusivity or not.